A week before, I installed a Aosp extender on my device, Motorola Moto E 1st generation. This is the initial official version of Oreo, but in alpha stage. That means it officially launched beta or unofficial version or initial stage of the development. But still, it is great. It is giving some great Oreo experience on my device. So let's take a in-depth look on this. To get the clear picture of this walkthrough, just turn on the subtitle. You have it. Now we move to the content. You know the specification of Motorola Moto E 1st Gen. It is a minimum low-end smartphone in market. It has only the basic configurations. But here, Oreo is working smoothly. There is no doubt, this device is eligible to get Oreo officially. Let's see something about this ROM. This is Aosp Extended, which stands for Android Open Source Project Extended. The motto of the developer is to give the pure Android feel what you get on Google phones. But not only that, you have some extensions. That's why they added extended on their name. In the extension, you will get some decent and advanced settings like modification on status bar, notification panel, navigation buttons, recents, lock screens. Even you can do some tweaks on your system. This is the difference between normal Aosp and Aosp extended. Now we see something about feature of this ROM. As I mentioned in earlier, this ROM is in alpha version of Oreo, so it is initial stage. So literally it contains some major issues. We will see that in later. In home screen, you have the pure featured pixel launcher. It's not like a normal launcher. You have some options here. You can add the icon pack and you have the option to change the icon mask. Also, this launcher has app hiding feature inbuilt. These things are the speciality of this ROM. In app drawer, as usual, normal UI like what Oreo have or has. And now the status bar. It's same like Oreo, but the brightness control is little bit different. You don't have the auto or adaptive brightness toggle in the slider, but you have the keys to level the brightness step by step. Now we see something about performance and battery drainage. The performance wise, there is no problem. It is in the flow. The booting time also not bad. The responsive wise, it's cool. There is no problem on performance. The battery drainage wise, it's okay. It's standing 2 days. That's enough for this device. But they should improve that little bit. So these are all the advantages of this ROM. Now we see some problems, bugs and disadvantages of this ROM. First of all, this ROM does not supporting auto orientation. If you installed this ROM, you only can watch the video in portrait, not in landscape. And the second major drawback is there is no music player, so the audio files will not work. Yeah, you can install the third party music players, but welcome to 2080, that's really disappointing one. And the Bluetooth not working, my device does not detecting this device. Camera is working perfectly, but video recording not, it is hanging at the end. Memory card slot working fine. And this ROM initiated the feature of PIP mode, which is picture in picture, but that also not working. Some major sensors also not working, but it's okay. Anyway, the developer fixed these things means I am definitely telling this ROM will be my daily driver on this device. They initiated all the cool features in alpha version. So definitely they will fix all the problems and you can also try this ROM. I will leave those forum links in the description. And a month before, I published a video about AOSCP version 5.0 cupcake. If you not yet watched that, means just go and watch. I done some motion shots there. So and yeah, that's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, just leave a like, and considering this subscription is good thing because I made 2 to 3 videos per week. So stay tuned with me and thank you for watching. I will see you guys in my next good one. Kot moto.